Looking for a workhorse, or maybe a car to fit your active lifestyle? How about a Nissan NP300 Navara?
This test car weighs just below 2 tons and can carry just above a ton. It can also tow up to 3.5 tons, so I guess it will be useful on a construction site or in a gardening business. It also has proper four-wheel drive, so with good off-road tires, Navara should cope in the rough stuff. This is the third generation of Nissan's modern-day pickup, but if you go back further, Nissan traces it 12 generations back to a 1933 Datsun. Navara name was first used in 2005, but NP300 goes back to 1997. For Europe, current third generation NP300 Navara is made in Spain. Navara also has siblings, Renault Alaskan and Mercedes-Benz X-Class. Nissan Navara comes as a 4-seater king cab or a 5-seater double cab. This affects the bed length. You can also choose a chassis cab to install whatever you need. This is a double cab and this bed is about 155 by 155 centimeters, about 110 centimeters wide by the floor between the wheel arches. There are several types of bed covers, including a hardtop. You can also have a plastic or aluminium bed floor.
Access to the tailgate is independent of the central lock, so you just open and close it with a lock here. You pull out a key out of the fob. Now, this car has keyless access and keyless ignition, so I suggest you make a copy of this key here so you don't lose it when pulling it in and out of the key fob, because you're going to lose either the key or the fob.
Perhaps you don't see it here in the back, but this is the top spec Tecna model. There is a leather upholstery and a sunroof option if you wish. Regardless of the trim, double cab always gets 2 ISOFIX mounts. Seat can be raised. The old Navara had a plastic shelf back here. Now you get access to tools, which I would normally expect to be behind the seats. Perhaps this saves some space, but new room is about the same like in the Ranger, which I'm testing at the same time. Tunnel is almost flat, but the floor is higher, so you have less headroom than in Ford's pickup. In the front, it's all Tecna trim luxury, namely a 7-inch infotainment screen. It's not the most modern system out there, but it gets Nissan's 360-degree camera, which makes parking this 5.3-meter car easier. There's good storage, 12-volt sockets, USB port. The dials are clear. It's not the most refined cockpit, but this is not what I expect from a workhorse.
Spending a lot of time with a workhorse like this, I would expect some minimum comfort. Nissan says these seats were developed together with NASA, so this is like space technology. Well, maybe it is space technology, but it doesn't have lumbar support adjustment. On Polish market specifically, there is no lumbar support adjustment across the range, not even as an option, unless you take the leather trimmed electric seats, which are available in Poland only on Tecna spec. Then with the electric seats you get 8 ways adjustment, and I suppose there is lumbar support there, but on normal seats like that, nothing. In Ford Ranger you get lumbar support adjustment across the range regardless of trim level.
Like in the Ranger, also here roof railing is reserved for higher spec models. You also get LED daytime running lights.
So how's this 5.3 meter pickup to drive? Well, surprisingly easy, actually. Navara has a 12.4 meters turning circle, which is about the same as in BMW 7 Series. Now, okay, BMW 7 Series is a big limo, but it's not a truck.
New Navara has a Euro 6 diesel under the bonnet. This means using AdBlue. This test example is powered by a 190 horsepower, 2.3 diesel with 450 newton meters of torque. There is also a less powerful 160 horsepower version. Nissan claims the 190 horsepower variant will use about 6.4 liters per 100 kilometers combined, 7.5 in the city. I'm getting about 7.5 combined, 8.5 in the city, without load, of course. Double cab also gets new multi-link rear suspension, which makes this car better to drive on the road.